地球上最神秘的岛屿，其中就包括智利复活节岛上著名的摩艾石像。让考古学家不解的是，岛上有将近900尊的摩艾像，地面之下还有身体，而且比地面上的石像更加巨大。
石像全部都是长了长脸、高鼻梁、深眼窝、长耳朵，双手呢放在肚子上有的。然后呢，这个样子就和岛上的居民长得完全不一样。
特别的五官，细长的手指头，放眼望去，世界上没有一种族群长得跟摩艾石像相似。仔细看看，有些石像头上还戴着红色帽子，有些石像的五官更完整，因为雕刻上眼睛。摩艾石像如此巨大，光是头部就是一般人类的好几倍，在它旁边任何人都显得渺小，因为高度跟重量都相当惊人。
整个复活节岛上一共有887尊充满神秘的巨大雕像，高呢一般在10到20米之间，重呢一般是50吨左右，但是最重的一个高有22米，重有300多吨。50吨以下的石头，现代的起重机是可以进行搬运的，但是100吨以上的东西，今天的科技也无能为力。
又高又重又大，一般人要制作摩艾石像简直是不可能的任务。再继续往下挖，摩艾石像不只有大大的头部，它还有身体，一直以来都埋在土里。
Originally, it was thought that these imposing statues only featured gigantic heads gazing solemnly toward the horizon. However, through the persistent efforts of archaeologists and researchers, the true marvels of these monolithic wonders were eventually unveiled.
A recent discovery in 2012 unearthed a mysterious revelation related to the Maui statues. The bodies attached to the large heads of the statues have distinctive symbols and designs which were originally thought to be tattoos. The depictions were only discovered upon withdrawing the statues and discovering them on the back of the statues' bodies. Experts were confused as to why the bodies were decorated when they were kept underground for no one to see.
摩艾石像的身体曝光比长期暴露在外的头部还要更长更大，而且背面还雕刻着我们看不懂的符号跟图案。难道这些是外星人留下的讯息吗？仔细看看这些摩艾石像，有几尊在海岸线整齐的排列，专注地凝视着远方，仿佛看着人们未知的宇宙。也有些摩艾石像散落在不同地方，究竟如何搬运是一大谜团。另外也有雕刻到一半的摩艾石像，仿佛时间突然停止，他们被迫暂停。
Archaeologists found unfinished moai left at the quarry.
岛上最大的一尊摩艾高21.3米，但还没有完工，它就静静地躺在拉诺拉拉库采石场里。也是这一尊摩艾让我们知道了，这些巨石像是从采石场里直接凿出来，然后运输到特定位置的。
要搬运得要有巨人般的力气，越过陡峭的山坡，放上平台，这是人类不可能做到的。
The moai are enormous blocks of stone, and they moved several hundred of them from the quarry quite some distance to the platforms around the edge of the island. And there have been many theories over the years as to how they were moved.The first theories thought that they must have been dragged horizontally on sledges or rollers or something of that kind.
真的有可能吗？但这个理论很快被反驳，因为木质滚筒根本无法支撑上百吨的重量，而且在这座孤独小岛上几乎看不到什么高大的树木，一切回到原点。到底如何移动摩艾石像？站在科学的论点，专家提出了这一种办法。
2011年，卡尔利波和特里亨特在《考古科学杂志》上发表论文称，用3根绳索就能够实现石像的直立行走。利波和亨特的研究团队找来了18名志愿者，将他们分成了3个小组，分别站在石像的左右两侧和后面，每个小组拉着一根绳索的末端，3根绳索都卡在石像深邃的眼槽里。左右两边的小组通过摆动石像使石像前移，后面的小组则拉住绳索，防止石像向前倾倒。通过这种方法，18名志愿者在1个小时里就让一尊高3米、重4.35吨的混凝土石像复制品移动了100米，而且远远看去，石像就真的像是自己在行走。
千古谜团就这么破解了吗？恐怕没有这么简单，因为这个复制版本的石像重量不到5吨，真正的摩艾石像重达80多吨，最重的更是上百吨。如果以同样的方式，人力搭配绳索，还有可能像这样移动吗？
One has to wonder if mana was some type of extraterrestrial technology that allowed these stones to be levitated into place.
1000多年前，印度的这座凯拉萨神庙，整座庙宇是从上往下盖，甚至刻在同一块巨大的岩石上。古人究竟如何办到？
坚硬的山壁中，锋利地切割出一个长方形凹槽，壮观的天然洞穴里，还伫立着一座雕刻细致的神庙。1500年前的凯拉萨神庙，是一座无法用科学解释的山壁石雕建筑。千年以前的古印度人，怎么会有如此高超的测量技术和精湛的雕刻能力？至今为止，这座神庙的建造过程，始终是考古学家们困惑的巨大谜团。
In the shadowed depths of Maharashtra's ancient landscape lies a mystery carved in stone, the Kailasa Temple. A monumental enigma, this architectural titan at the Ellora Caves was not built, but actually carved from a single solitary rock.
3层楼高，神庙外观高度是雅典帕德嫩神庙的2倍。1500年前没有起重设备的古印度人，到底要如何办到？难解释的是，考古学家发现这座神庙并不是从地基往上搭建，而是从顶部开始往下凿刻。当时的人们又为何要刻意选择一种最困难的盖庙方式？更加困惑的是，凯拉萨神庙的建筑材料至始至终就只有山壁上的岩石。换句话说，古人就是徒手拿着原始工具，一凿一凿从山壁上直接刻出一整座庙宇，难度之高足以想象。从最高层的屋顶接着往下刻出门窗，再刻出神庙内的每一尊石像、人像。如此壮观的神庙，让人怀疑真的是古印度人用锤子和凿子雕刻而成吗？
The precision with which they had to work to avoid errors is remarkable, as any mistake made in carving could not be undone and would have potentially ruined the entire structure.
神庙整体建筑相当复杂，千年古文明竟然早就运用水利系统，这也表示1500年前的古印度文明似乎比历史记载的还要厉害。
It is a well thought out architectural masterpiece with bridges, balconies, staircases, underground tunnels, drainage systems, rainwater irrigation networks, and hidden passages all carved from the same rock.
Some historians estimate that construction of the temple required the removal of over 400,000 tons of rock. But even more incredible is that mainstream archaeologists propose that this feat was accomplished in just 18 years.
当时的人们只花18年就徒手刻好复杂神庙，光是这一点也让考古学家们不敢置信。
If people worked every day for that 18 years for 12 hours straight with no breaks, then they would have to have removed 5 tons of rock every hour. This is 10,000 pounds of rock every hour.In reality, such a feat is not even possible today with modern technology.
另外一个无法解释的现象是，根据神庙大小计算，从山壁凿出来的碎石至少有40万吨，但在神庙周围却完全看不见上万吨的碎石堆积痕迹，而这些碎石怎么会神秘消失？
But we do not find any evidence of rocks being piled up nearby. It hasn't been used to build any other temples or any other structure. Where did all that rock go?
同样给不出答案的，还有屋顶上的这一个神秘记号。
Moreover, the temple's Mahamantapa roof, adorned with 4 lion sculptures, each with a raised paw, forms a compelling and mysterious arrangement. This unique configuration, when observed from an aerial perspective, seems to converge into an X shape, sparking theories about their purpose as potential aerial markers.